A very good morning to all. Today I will give you a lecture on topic techniques of separation of mixture. So, to understand this topic, we first have to know the meaning of separation and mixture. So, I will start with separation. Separation simply means getting rid of unwanted impurities. Now here, unwanted impurities means the substances which are not pure and we have to separate them from the mixture to make it clean and pure mixture. Now what does mixture actually is? Mixture are made by mixing two or more substances without chemical combination. Now here without chemical combination means it is free from chemical, but generally it is a mixing of two or more substances in it. So now I will give you little more detail about this topic and then we will study about techniques of separation of mixtures. Now most of the time, the substances that we see around us are not in their pure form. They are basically a mixture of two or more substances in it. The impurities present in the mixture are removed by different techniques. Now, some techniques you have already observed in your daily life. For example, you have observed your mother separating stones from the pulse and rice. She uses hand-picking method in it, which is a technique used to separate solid from the mixture. Secondly, you drink filtered tea. That tea comes from the So now we will study about types of mixture. Generally, mixture is of two types, homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture are that mixture in which composition is uniform throughout the mixture. It means you can separate all solids, impure materials from the substance. Now, filtered tea. The example I have also given earlier that you always drink filtered tea by removing all solids and impure substances from the tea. Now, heterogeneous mixture. It is a mixture in which composition is not uniform. It means we cannot separate the mixture by common methods such as hand picking, filtration, thrashing, like techniques. There are different methods to separate these mixtures. For example, milk is a heterogeneous mixture and blood also. Milk, because it is a colloid, it contains proteins, fat and carbohydrates which cannot be separated by sieving, hand picking, etc. method. So now we are on our last heading of today's lecture, that is techniques. So there are many techniques to separate mixture. First is hand picking. It is simply picking undesired substances by hand only and separating them by useful ones. The separating substances may be impurity. Yes, it is impure substance that must be separated or thrown away. For example, small pieces of stone from the wheat, rice and pulses are the examples of hand picking techniques. So now we are on a second technique, that is threshing. This technique is mostly done during harvesting of crop. Generally the stalks of wheat means stems of wheat are dried once it is harvested. Thus, then we receive bundle of dried crops, plant stems or stalks with the grains attached to the top. A thin layer of chaff covers the grains attached to the stems or stalks. Then grains are separated from the stems and stalk as well as from the chaff. So, threshing is the process of beating wheat or paddy stems to separate them from grains as well as from stems and the chaff that covers the grains. As grains are heavier, they get separated by the stems when beaten. A third type, that is winnowing. It is simply a process of separation of husk from the grain by using wind. For example, a farmer threshes wheat in his field. He gets a mixture of wheat grain and husk. So, husk is separated by wheat grains by winnowing with the help of winnowing basket. And the husk is separated because husk is light, it can be separated by wind. And wheat grains are heavy, so it cannot be separated by wind. So this is winnowing. Now we are on our fourth type, that is sieving. It is a process of parting a mixture using sieve. Parting means separating. A sieve is a shallow means deep container with small holes at the bottom. Sieving is used to separate solid mixture that contains component of varying sizes, different sizing. For example, wheat brought from the fields contain impurities as stones such as stalks. So it is placed on sieve and through this impurities are removed. It is also used to obtain fine sands. Technique is evaporation. You all are known to evaporation. It is a technique of separating a mixture, most commonly a solution of solvent and a soluble solid. The solution is heated and until the organic solvent evaporates, turning a gas, mostly leaving behind the solid residue. In this method, evaporating is an effective process for separating soluble solid from a liquid. It is an effective process of separating solid from the liquid. So, last technique is centrifugation. It is a process or technique used for separation of tiny particles from a liquid that can easily pass through filter paper. It is used for carrying out separation of insoluble particles where normal filtration fails to work well. They are saying that where normal filtration process fails to work, there is a technique used as centrifugation to do further process. Thank you. This is all about today's lecture.